Hi guys, today intro video for the next teardown. We have here out of my garage Collins 6218-3. It is called an ATC transponder. So guys, we have here 12 kilos of analog signal processing and RF goodness made in USA. So as you can see, it is a regular aircraft rack module with a typical red Collins strip at the top. Seems it is formerly from the Scandinavian Air System Company. We have on the front here self-test push button, some green monitor light, some BNC connections, and probably the main antenna output. So this thing, guys, is quite impressive because it is not 20 centimeters deep, it is not 40 centimeters deep, it is 60 centimeters deep. So on this side you cannot see pretty well, but if I flip it around, guys, here is what we have. And you can already see a little teaser of insides through the vent holes. So it is all modular construction, very well made. So the first video of the teardown will be about the general construction of the thing, and then the next videos will be a detailed look at the at some of the modules, the most interesting ones, I guess. So on the front here you can see a big cavity with a power transmitting tube. It is a vacuum tube transmitter, and here all the modules with components. On the back side of it, just one big multi-pin connector. As you can see, not a huge number of contacts here, but pretty thick contacts. Here is the only lock screw for the cover. Other side, you can see more of stuff. So it is in overall good condition, very few dents and missing paint. It was very well packed, in fact, while in storage. So on the bottom here you can see the base plate with more vent holes. There is no fan in it. Okay, I got it from a contact I found on eBay quite a long time ago. I have it for maybe 6 years or something like this. So it was a dude I got, I purchased one thing from him on eBay. And then he contacted me directly and with photos of more stuff. And we made some transactions out of eBay. It was not expensive, I believe. It was maybe 40 euros or something like this, because it was he was really wanting to get rid of it because it was too bulky for him to keep. And he was collecting more vintage, more older parts. No, so it was not his main interest. Okay, so it is a big thing, and the size will be very pretty. Lots of old school US made parts. Very, very well made. No circuit boards. These are all terminal solder post assembly. So it will be in the next video. We will remove the cover and have a first look at the general construction of the thing. for now. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Hi guys, today we will remove the cover of the Collins transponder. Let me adjust my camera. By the way, on the bottom here you can see my little switch I have under my desk. So, yes, I will remove the cover. So it is not very easy to work on this thing because it is very bulky. So it is just a matter of removing one lock screw and sliding out the cover, revealing all the goodies. Here we are. So it is just an aluminium sheet cover, folded and welded, very light. So guys, here is what we have inside, a first view. So it is all modular construction. You can see all these plates here can be removed with red screws. There are connectors behind allowing easy replacement. So they are screwed onto four main structural frame parts. And there is in the middle intermediate frame with keeping in place connectors, wirings and EV parts. So we will have a look at the modules one at a time. So on this right side we have a decoder module, an encoder module, another encoder module, not the same part number. This is a blank panel. Here is some of the radio frequency stuff. With, you can see coax wires going to it. Connectors, high frequency connectors. I don't remember the name for these ones. SMA maybe. You can see it is aluminum parts with here welded. Welds on the aluminum. So if I remove this panel, with blank panel, we will have a look at the inside kind of stuff you can find inside. So the screws have lock nuts. These are very hard to remove by hand. It is why it is better to use power tool. So here you can see the inside frame. The structural part keeping connectors in place on the wirings and some EV components as this delay network. Let me zoom in focus. Yes, so it must be some delay lines, a set of delay lines made by ESC Corp in Palisades Park, New Jersey. And here is a pinout because it is a tube socket kind of pinout with the bottom side. Here we have some high voltage capacitor. Okay, so next side, the top side. We have some, so it is upside down, sorry. We have here something it is not written what it is. Self-test module, it seems. The power supply module with quite weird parts. So it is just a general overview, and after we will have a detailed look at each one. Here we have a modulator with high voltage shielding here. Transmitter cavity with fuse holders. So one interesting thing about this device, most of the transistors are socketed in fact, and you can pull them right off like so, and there is nothing in fact really keeping them in place apart from the socket. So it seems it is good enough, but for an aircraft grade part you should expect some security feature in order to prevent them from pulling loose with vibrations. And here it is the testing. You have this relay, little shielded relays, and in fact it is symmetrical. So you can reverse the way it is inserted, and it seems it will still work because there is nothing here indicating the correct way of inserting it. Okay, do I have any dead code? Yes, I have a 1968 dead code here, guys. So it is a late 60s technology, quite interesting. It must be why we have no integrated circuit. So on this side, more modules. This side is fully populated, as you can see. So we have a decoder module. In fact, they are all decoder. This black thing here are big delay lines. You can see lots of transistors and resistors and capacitors, all this kind of stuff, and all soldered on a small solder post with Teflon insulators. Some test points here. This at the end is the cavity with a transmitting vacuum tube, which can be accessed by removing this cover. And on the last side here we have monitor module and IF amplifier module in a shielded can. And by the way, if you did not notice yet, look at this shielding color, guys. Yes, it is silver coated. This part is silver coated. This part is silver coated on the big cavity cylinder at the other side too. And maybe some more parts in the middle. So, really spare no expense here, guys. It is really, really impressive. And you can see there are some weird components. Some stuff you do not see usually. Like this one, for example, it will be, we will look at it in detail in a later video. Okay, next video will be a zoom in look at all that stuff. And after this, we will start removing parts. Thanks for watching, bye bye. Hi guys, today, zoom in look at the parts from the Collins transponder to have a first view of a kind of components we find on it. So I will not do everything because in fact everything is basically the same. We have, so as I said in the previous video, all the transistors are socketed like so. With they are all golden leg transistors, by the way. And they are mostly from Texas Instruments, and mostly the 2N series. 2N337, 2N1224. Of course, all made in USA. The resistors seems to be carbon. Resistors, old school carbon resistors with a brown bakelite body. We have a small shielded capacitors like this one, military grade probably. Mica capacitors. And here, for instance, we have regular ceramic disc capacitors. So this thing here is a puller to remove the module, and here also this metal part is a puller. We have some unusual stuff like this black cylinder. I do not know what it is. It is a four-leg cylinder. The diodes are glass body diodes. Some are contact point diodes like this one. We can see inside the contact point. The standoffs are golden standoffs with Teflon base, press fit in the aluminum plates here. Here, is it in the frame? Yes. We have trimmers, so regular, maybe bigger than usual, but a regular shape multi-turn trimmers with screw head at the end. Here on the inside we have a number of this kind of metal boxes with glass insulated contacts, so either transformers, delay lines and such. If I flip it this way, is it still in focus? Barely, yes. Some bigger resistors, but you can see always the same stuff. A Texas Instruments 2N transistors. Some little trimmers here. And we can see through the holes here more little trimmers in this shielded box. So by the way, here we have this box contains the main back connector. And here at the bottom, you cannot see it, there are capacities pass-through for EMI protection probably. Here at the end, you can see the kind of high-frequency connector they use. It looks more or less like a SMI connector, but there is a screw-in part. And this, guys, is the transmitting vacuum tube behind this cover. We will look at it later. Nice little cover with spring contact stuff. And you must align the slot. Okay. On this side, we have a front panel with the push button, the light, the BNCs here. And we have a vacuum tube cavity with one other kind of high frequency connector here. But at least this one, you can, it is like a BNC almost, but it is with a screw. This one is easy to remove without towel at least. You put it back in place immediately. Well, later maybe. This zip tie here is probably not original. Oh, not sure in fact, because we are over zip ties here. I'm not sure, I don't remember if I did add them myself. Yes, probably in fact. Because you can see elsewhere there is wax cord to keep the wires in place, so it is probably remade, as I didn't have the correct stuff to remake. At least functionality is okay, but it does not have the same vintage look. Okay, you can see by the way, all this is silver plated. Here we have a few solders, nothing special. So here you can see these boxes are delay lines probably, or filter networks. Completely potted in epoxy or bakelite stuff. Very hard. More mica capacitors, more transistors here. And it is it, in fact it is the same thing all the way around, but behind the modules we have different things, if I remember correctly. It is why we have we will remove them later and have a look at the backside of the modules. This is a bigger delay line. On the top we have so last side, in fact, seems we have high voltage stuff here for the transmitting modulator with this plastic shield. And I can see at the bottom here Teflon sheet. More mica capacitor. This is weird, guys. Look, a little toroidal thing with six legs. It almost looks like a bug. Really interesting. And here is the power supply section. You can see we have big electrochemical capacitors. These black things here look like solenoids, but no, they are in fact power resistors. This is a bridge rectifier in a black, little black box, you can see. And here at the back we have a bigger bridge rectifier with a regular metal body diodes. Okay, so I believe it is all for now. We will just have another look at this side here. On the radio frequency section, so you can see the main coax coming from the antenna plug, presumably. I believe it is the antenna plug. Going in some stuff, it must be the switcher between transmit and receive, probably. And I do not know how many high frequency plugs we have on it. Yes, in fact we have one output here, it seems, going to somewhere else. And here at the top side we have a cylinder, a tube, metal tube, which more or less looks like a waveguide. It is poking out at this side here, so it must be a waveguide. And here maybe we are picking up something, either the transmitting power or it is the pickup for receiving. Quite interesting. So here is the one beast of a module. The markings here are erased, sadly. But here no. And in fact you can see the the components inside. So same things are mounted on a solder post. Okay, okay. So in the next video we will start removing modules and having a look at them, the oversize. For now, if you want, you can use this as a computer background. I think it is quite nice. So thanks for watching, bye bye. Hi, next video about the teardown of Collins transponder. So we'll have a look at how the modules can be removed. So if I remember correctly, these big side modules have direct plug-in connectors, and there may be some DB connectors even. Quite amazing for such old device. No, they are Centronics. At least this one is Centronics. And yes, made in 1968, already using Centronics. Or, very similar to Centronics. Here you can see the backside of one module and the wiring behind it. So it is how the modules get removed. This one at least. And if I remember correctly, we have here another kind of connector. The way you really want a power tool for removing such screws. Yes, here we have a small connector mounted on wires like so. So everything is nicely labeled and you can see the wiring at the bottom. So it is the two kind of connections you can find in this thing, plus the quartz connectors. So it would be interesting to have a look at all the back side of the modules, but I believe they will be quite the same everyone. Okay, so in the next video we will have a look at the close look at the all of most of the modules. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Hi. So I did remove all of the modules from the Collins transponder, and I believe it will be easier for me first if we have a look at the naked frame here. And then, when we have a look at the modules one by one, I will be able to put them back in place, and it will be easier for me. So I did remove everything except the cavities thing, because there are wires to unsolder. By the way, I have already one loose wire here, but it was already almost detached. But here there are several solder wires all around, so we will have a look in situ of this thing. So here is what it looks when it is naked. We will have a better look immediately. And yes, my memory was right. There are also DB connectors here. So it is using maybe for the first time, or very very early at least, DB and Centronics connectors, okay, before 1970, so it is quite impressive. It is strange there are no PCBs in this thing at all. All solder post mounted components, but quite modern connectors. Okay, so we will have a look, detailed look now at this. So here it is upside down, but we have the top of the cavity part. It is written transmitter on it. By the way, you have a wire soldered onto it. The fuse is here. I cannot open the holders; they are very very hard. These three nuts here seems there are some stuff to be adjusted, probably. Capacitors or inductors. If we go around, so this frame is made of aluminium, extruded aluminium rails. Here we have two DB connectors for the top modules, mounted a little loose so they can move when inserting the modules. A little relay panel here with wire pickups. Not relays, but for relaying the wiring. Here at the bottom we have a shielded box around the main connector. And you can see there is stuff written. It is a number of pass-through capacitive filters. I believe. And apart from that, as the connector seems to be very deep, there must be only wires inside, probably, but it is tedious to remove, so I will not take it apart. Here are the two cables going to this self-test module, which was here. You can see the little multi-pin connector and the little coax. Here on the side, we have more Centronics kind connectors. Wire loom here. And we can try to remove this part in order to see what we have zoomed here in. So if I can undo this screw, yes, it is not tight at all. It is maybe the signal injection where they inject the signal to the amplifier tube. One of the other leads must be the high voltage to it. Yes, it is coming off. We have here, what do we have? We have just a metal strip going to the, from between the signal from the, this BNC, the center of this BNC connector, to ground. It is quite weird. So I will put it back in place later. On the bottom here, we have a main wire loom going all around. All the long. We have outputs of the two boxes, gray boxes, we will look at them later. And we have a main interesting thing, the transmitting tube. If I remove this cover, I have just to turn a little bit two screws, and I believe it will come right off. Maybe, yes, it is screwed on. Yes, there is an aluminium cover, like so. And here is the tube, guys. So I think I must pull on it in order to remove it. If I remember correctly, I did already remove it previously. So it must be possible. Let's try to pull on it gently. Oh, it does not want to come off. I do not remember exactly how to remove it, as I do not want to break it. I believe there is a photo of it on my Flickr, so I will link the photo. It is better than trying again to remove it and breaking it, as it is not the current very easy to find vacuum tube. It is a ceramic power transmitting vacuum tube, so probably not something you can get easily. Golden and ceramic, very beautiful item, but I do not want to break it. Okay, so what can we look else here? We have these boxes, cavities, filtering or something. This cover here is easy to remove, at least. It is a silver coated cover. Two screws, and here we are. You can see air mount components. There is a quartz transistor and passive stuff. There is this standoff here with a Teflon around it. And here is the backside of a cover. So nothing special here. here it will be the same stuff. And here we have two big boxes. They are, both of them are delay networks. You have a specification written here if you want to research it, but I believe it will be quite hard. Okay, thanks for watching for now, bye bye. Hi guys, today we will have a better look at two modules of Collins transponder. So for today it will be the power supply and the modulator unit. Because so far you did see this side, but you did not see the underside, which looks like this. So let's have a look at it. So we start with the power supply unit. Here is the backside of it. And yes, they are DB connectors. So the way these things are made, you have a U-shaped aluminum plate. And extra plates are screwed on it to hold the components. And behind there are a few parts and mostly wires. So this one is not worth removing, it is just wires behind. So here, as I said previously, we have a small relay. You have a schematic here on it, made by CP Claire and Company, 26.5 volts DC, 600 amperes. Oh, excuse me, 600 ohms, not 600 amperes. And the blue dot is one of the coil sides. We have two, each side here, two power resistors made by Dale. You can barely see the brand here. And the way these things are attached, you have these nuts here. Mica spacers, washers, and screw at the other side. You have module mounting screws. You can see, you cannot lose them. There is a small ring keeping them in place. The bridge rectifier here, there is nothing special, there is no brand on it, no info. The diodes here are regular metal can diodes. So on this side, we have a big Sangamo capacitor, in completely shielded, as you can see on the side here. There is a metal shield and glass insulator for the lid. Each side is like this. So it must be non-polarized capacitor. 0.27, it must be 0.27 microfarads. This transformer here, so this one just looks like a regular transformer. This one is made by Balastron. You can see it is painted in black. And there is this kind of weird stuff coming out of it. So not sure if it did over it maybe. And some of the internal coating did spray out. Quite interesting. And here you have the wires going at the other side, and you can see they did make a little lip in the metal to protect the wires again against cutting with the metal. So really, really nicely made. The other part. So we have, it is the modulator section. As you can see, it is still the same construction with layers of metals, metal, the bug thing here, mica capacitors, steel transistors mounted on plates, on standoffs, I mean. And here we have this danger shield, made in some kind of plastic sheet. And what do we have behind it? If I can remove it, this is turning, not turning the correct way. I believe we have capacitors or something like this, or maybe it is just the lid from the part of the other side. Will it come off or not? No. So I will not disturb it if it does not want to come off. By the way, we have, you can see there is a Teflon. Oh, some people are making noise outside. Some Teflon sheet here. The pullers for the connector on this side. We have this module, which is probably either a transformer or inductor. Probably transformer. You can see some of the leads here have glass or porcelain insulators. So it must be high voltage, this side. Made by Balastron with that code of 1968. And this high voltage capacitor, danger high voltage at all time. There is no high voltage, so it is not true. Made by Sprague, vitamin Q capacitor. You always need vitamins in your capacitors. Probably, maybe, even nice PCB oil vitamins. Very, very great. 2 × 0.5 something microfarad, 500 volts DC. Made in USA, of course, date code of 6752. So made between Christmas and Christmas and New Year. And you can see the insulator connections here have plastic insulators like what you see on a microwave oven transformers, in fact. Okay, so it is all for these two modules. Thanks for watching.
Hi guys, today two small modules from the Collins transponder. One interesting and one not so interesting. We will start with the one not so interesting. In fact, there is nothing special on this one. It is called the monitor module. You only have transistors and passives. You can see here the backside of transistor sockets. Two small trim pots, very, very small. And they are, I try not to move the piece too much, they are connected with small wires. So it is not so usual, this kind of setup for trimmers, but I did already see it also in on a Soviet made trimmers. So maybe they did copy this design at one point. Here you can see the backside of a Teflon shoulder post. Some of them have dual sided, this one are single sided. Still the same screw with red heads. Still the same Texas Instrument transistors for most of them. This one has a different logo, I do not recognize this logo. It is very, very small, by the way. And they are all socketed. They are not hard to remove from the socket. This one has a little dent. And here is the plug for the module. Reference number and serial number on each of the parts. So the other module, it seems to be the self-test module. And here we have some RF stuff, guys. We have two of these things, which seems to be filters, FL1, FL2, with a frequency written in megacycles written on it. On the end of it, we have here we have a screw, so it must be an something you can adjust, either a capacitor or an inductor inside. Here is the RF connector for it, either input or output. So we have two shielded modules. There is some kind of wave guide or RF conduit between these boxes. And we have two modules shielded with silver coating. So first I will have a look at this one. So here is what it looks inside. In fact, it is pretty much like the other one on the near the big cavity in the main transponder frame. Two debug mounted transistors with mica washers behind them, quartz here, one more trimmer here, contact point diode here in a glass package. And passive stuff. Okay, this you can see it must be capacitors with ground shielding maybe. And these are just pass-through with capacitive decoupling. Here one little adjustable capacitor probably with a screw at the end. Okay, the other side we have this box which contains component number CR2. I believe it will be a high frequency diode. Yes, look at this guys. In a little socket. Usually they are mounted the other way, they are plug-in diodes. But here they did mount it in a lit. I will try not to break it because you cannot find them. Yes, it is called a microwave diode, MA41727, microwave and diode logo, golden contacts, ceramic body and nothing else. It is mounted in its own little shielding box. So you can find on the web on YouTube information about why to use a diode in a microwave signal environment. It is interesting. Here we have a weird thing with six legs and a black body. Own body. Not sure what it is. Here, it seems it is a transformer. At least the part number here is T3. So, is it for the Q4 must be the transistor here? Probably this one had, yes, Q3, Q4, not sure. Here we have a T2, and this thing must be also a wound toroidal transformer, wound around a small toroid, and dipped in some coating. Here we have old school capacitor, look at this, it looks like capacitors in old radios. Ceramic tube capacitor, probably. Here we have ceramic disc capacitor, something very usual. Some test points, which seems to meet the resistor color code. Brown, red, orange. And it is all for this module. I can see more trimmers here at the bottom. with access on here. Yeah, so it seems to be the module that does the self-test. So probably it generates a signal and they see if it is received correctly. These two things here are adjustable capacitors also, flat capacitors, as in you can see in old radios. Okay, so I will put this together. Thanks for watching for now. Bye bye. Hi guys, today a quick look at some of the bigger modules of the Collins transponder, because they are all made exactly the same way, except this one is upside down. So what do we have on them? In fact, we have so components on this side, on solder post, as you did see previously. We have a test point with a resistor color cord. We have more or less interesting parts as this filter or delay line. Here is some kind of handle to pull the module, because at the other side we have the plug, Centronics plug here on this one. And here is the back side, they are all the same. Lots of wires, handmade point-to-point wires. Stamp serial number, some quality control stamps, and in fact it is all. So if this device had to be scrapped, sadly, what you could retrieve could only be the transistors. The socket seems to be riveted to the plate, so they are not possible to remove. The passives here, you may be able to desolder them and retrieve some of them, but the legs are sometimes quite short. But at least it may be easy to remove them. Of course, I will not do it. It is just a consideration. If you find a similar transponder in a very bad condition and you want to take it apart and recover parts. But this one is museum quality, so of course I will keep it. These are obscure parts, probably you cannot reuse them. Yes, they are they are delay lines, it seems. 0.4 microseconds and 0.1 microsecond. 500 and 1000 ohms inductance. Nice trim pots here. And the Centronics plug. Yeah, still the same thing. Nothing special. Trim pots are not the same kind here, they are smaller, made by Dale. And again, lots of parts and lots of wires on the other side. So, one interesting thing with if you get a broken all the avionics and you take them apart are the hardware, because they are here they are Imperial hardware. You do in Europa, at least, you do not find them quite easily, so they are worth being keeping. And most of the time they are not sure here, but you can have stainless steel hardware. Yes, it is stainless steel, so pretty expensive stuff. All the small nuts you may have are self-locking nut with a small plastic ring inside, so quite unusual stuff too. So you can see, in fact, it seems to be they are probably quite generic modules because they are extra holes. So maybe the same module plate design can be reused for something else, or options, or it is just extra space for further future modifications. Not sure. Or maybe it is just easier for them to have one tool that stamps all the holes. One model of tool, not sure. Yes, it must be stamped. You can see this cut here for the transistor. Okay, so in the next video will be the last. We will have a look in the big silver shielded module that was located under the transponder. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Hi guys, today we have a look at the last part of the transponder, this shielded module which was located at the bottom. So silver coated can here. You can see on the backside all the Teflon insulators for the standoffs, the wiring points. Here one, we have one DB9 connector, and here we have a golden coax connector. So I did already remove most of the screws. In fact, I am not even sure if it will open or not. I do not remember if I did open this previously, so yes, it is coming off. Okay, so first you can see the inside part of the cover is quite sad. The silver is all darkened. And here is the content. So I was wrong, well, not completely in fact, because previously I did say we have no PCB in here. This may look like a PCB, at least it is a PCB material, but there are no printed tracks on it. There are still solder posts coming through and with all the component legs soldered on it, and there are no printed tracks. So here you can see there are some unpopulated ones. Nice golden finish. So what do we have in here? We have a lot of dead bug transistors, a whole bunch of them, and in each section here we have one variable capacitor, small ceramic capacitor, and one thing at the back here. You cannot see it pretty well. It seems it is in some translucent compound, sealing compound, and it seems to be a small toroidal thing, so probably a small toroidal inductor or transformer. Yes, we have four contacts at the rear side, so there must be transformers. These are either inductors or resistors, probably inductors. And it is the same thing all the way along. Small trimmers here. Test points again. And well, it is all in fact what we have in it. More trimmers here. You can see here, spare no expense. Look, these trimmers are mounting onto this small bracket with screws. The screws have lock nuts, and there is this small piece stamped in just for the receiving the cover screw. Quite expensive assembly, and probably, well, surely even, this was all handmade, guys. These are where the short body resistors with golden tolerance ring. Quite impressive. Okay, so I will put this back together and maybe I will make a time-lapse reassembly video of the transponder. This will be nice. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.